Hello, CS scholars. How are you all? I hope you all are doing well. Okay, so our chapter 8 was going on, yes? Now, in the previous videos, we have studied about different types of feathers and different types of beak. So, today, in this chapter, we are going to see about feet. Yes, about feet of birds. So let us continue. Feet of birds. All birds have two feet with four toes each. Feet help birds to walk and hop on land. They also helps birds to catch and hold their food. Yes, so like with the help of our legs, we will walk at the same way with the help of feet, the bird will walk and hop on the land. And one more extra characteristics is that they can hold their food, whichever food they have catched, they can hold it with the help of the feet. Okay, so now let us see different birds are having different types of feet. So let us see which are these different types of feet. Okay, so first is perching feet. Let us read and understand what is perching feet. Some birds, such as parrots and pigeons, use their feet to hold onto branches of trees. Okay, so in the picture, can you see parrot? And parrot is sitting on a branch. So it is holding the branch with the help of the feet. Can you see in the image? Yes, that's why this is called perching. Means they have to hold the branch with the help of the feet, and this type of feet is known as perching feet. Perching feet prevent the bird from falling down from the trees. Yes, to keep themselves balanced so that they don't fall down from the tree, they will hold the branch tightly with the help of their perching feet. Okay, now let us see the next type. The next is talons. Yes, can you see in the image? Talons of eagle. Okay, flesh-eating birds such as hawks, eagles, and owls have very sharp claws called talons. So, can you see they are having sharp pointed claws? Yes. Why? Because they have to tear the flesh of other animals, like they tear with the help of their beak. In the same way, they also use their feet. These talons help the flesh-eating birds to pick up and hold small animals tightly. So, you know, these birds fly in the sky. Yes. So, whenever they see their prey, any animal, they go and quickly catch it with the help of their feet. So, they have this sharp pointed teeth so that the animal which they have caught, the prey, it will not fall down from the feet. Okay. Let us move further. Climbing feet. Climbing feet. Let us see what are climbing feet. Birds such as woodpeckers and hoppers have two toes directed upward and two toes directed downwards. This helps them to hold on to the tree while climbing. Yes, so at the time we were studying about the beak, we saw that this woodpecker, they create a hole in the tree. Yes, so they have to stand there on the tree. So they have two toes in upward direction and two toes in downward direction. So they will not fall down from the tree. And they have a grip on the tree and they can easily, with the help of the beak, put a hole in the tree and catch the insect. Okay, let us move further to the next type. This is scratching feet. Okay, so from the name, what we understand? Scratching something. Yes. Scratching birds such as hen and peacocks have feet with sharp claws to scratch the mud and dig out small insects. Yes, for digging, like we dig a pit, in the same way they have to dig the mud to find out small insects. So they have scratching feet. Okay, then we have webbed feet. Okay, so you can see in the picture the image of a webbed feet. Yes, it is very different. So let us see. The front toes in webbed feet are jointed together by the skin. Yes, can you see a continuous layer of skin is present? There is no gap in between the feet. So water birds such as ducks and geese have webbed feet. Why they have webbed feet? Because it acts like pedals and help these birds in swimming. Yes, we know that ducks and geese, they live in water. So they need to swim. So these webbed feet will help them to swim. Okay, moving further to the last type of feet, wedding feet. So some birds like crane and herons have thin, long legs that help them to wade through the water. So they also need to go through the water. Yes, so they have wading feet which helps them to move in the water. Okay children, so here we have stopped and we will see the next chapter, the remaining chapter, in our next video. Yes, so here we have completed our topic of feet. So in this chapter till now we have completed about feathers, beak, and today about feet. So rest of the chapter we will continue in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.